What's happening, y'all? It's your player partner, Dom of the Spook, Dom of the Icon. Just left the gym, hitting the bag, 40-pound weighted vest on. You know, put on the show for them folk. Shout out to my dog that I was having a conversation with in the comment section. Sparked this video. I'm finna give y'all. It's gonna be called Why. Or not Why, but just the darkness coming to the light, right? I'm gonna give y'all a story. This is a real story. And this is before I got on semen retention. Just a little transparency for y'all. So, this is how God works. God don't play about you, right? So, I used to date this woman, right? And now, this is back when I didn't have no control over my D, right? Was I messing around on her? Was I being committed in a relationship? Hell no, I wasn't. No excuses. I wasn't being committed. And so, when you set the vibration of not being committed, how do you expect loyalty? You know what I'm saying? But anyway, this is how it go. So, her birthday came up, and you know, this is me basically playing nice guy and wanting to basically show her my appreciation for her and that, you know, she stayed down with me through all my BS. You know what I'm saying? And I just want to do something nice for her for her birthday. And, make up for all of the bad stuff that I did to her, right? Now, mind you, we had stopped talking for a while. And then we got back with each other, right? So, this is what happened. I'm going to leave some details out, but I'm gonna basically tell y'all the main. So, basically what happened, I took her out to eat. So, the whole time, I got on my Snapchat. I'm recording. I'm like, look at the birthday girl, y'all. Queen this, queen that, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, she's smiling. You know, playing innocent. Right? Playing innocent like a mug. And so, usually she'll put me on her, like, this woman, she used to put me on her Instagram and, like, make whole goddamn letters out to me. Added me and all. Like, I love this man so much. He is the, like... And she really did. She really did. Probably to this day, she probably still love my dirty drawers, for real. I do not doubt it. Right? We was just growing. We was in the puppy love stage. So, we were just growing and learning, basically. So, I don't fault her for what she did. I had it coming too. Trust me, I had it coming. But look though, because there was the energy that I put out. But anyway, this basically what happened. I took out to eat, put on my Snapchat, all the good stuff. She didn't put me on hers, and it kind of like bothered me a little bit. But I let it slide because I'm like, it was just weird. Because I'm like, you used to do that, this, that, and the third, but now you kind of hide me. I'm like, what did you hide me for? You know? So, this is what happened. So, maybe a couple days passed, and something just was, it wasn't sitting right with me while I was laying up with her, right? So I go to sleep. And when I went to sleep, this is how God worked. I went to sleep and I had a dream that I went through her phone and saw a video of her fucking. But it seemed so damn real. So I'm just like, what the fuck? Like, I'm like, what are the odds, you know? So when I woke up, she didn't know that I knew her password. She didn't know. I'm slick as hell. Like, I'm slick. Like, I'm always paying attention. You might not think I am, but I'm slick as fuck. Like, I know how to play dumb and all that stuff, you know? So, what I did was, I woke up and I went through her phone. Right? And when I went through her phone, I didn't find nothing in the photos and shit, right? So I'm like, nah. I'm like, nah. Keep looking. Keep searching. You know? So I went to this app where it's basically like you save your photos under this app, you know, and you gotta have a password. Now I had to guess the password to it, but me and her was together for so long, I'm basically knowing what she would put as a password, right? So I got it on the first try, boom. Now when I went through her phone, man, I seen videos of us, you know, getting it on and shit. But I kept scrolling. Then I seen a nigga. But it wasn't my complexion. So I'm like, that's odd. Then, y'all, I went to this video and I seen her fucking getting hit from the back. And that shit traumatized me, man. that shit had me hot. And look, mind you, I'm laying right next to her while I'm looking at this shit. And boy, I'm getting heated just watching this shit. The nigga hitting her, but he not hitting her right. Like, I got to tell you, not fucking her like how I fuck her, you feel me? And he got his shirt all up, showing his abs and shit. And I'm like, oh yeah. So I go to the bathroom. Now, I ain't gonna lie, fool, I'm getting mad as fuck. I'm in the bathroom. I'm like, bro, what should you do? Should you just act like you ain't see it and just see what the fuck she gonna think she can get away with? I'm just trying to, cause I'm thinking, what my pops do? My pops play it cool, but nigga, I got my mama temper in me, and I'm just like, bro, when I'm heated, nigga, I can't hold on. I gotta let that shit. I can't suppress my anger. I ain't gonna lie, bro. If somebody got me, I got a small head, like, bro, I'm gonna go crazy. So nigga, I woke her ass up out of sleep. Nigga, I get the going off. But not like snapping. I'm more so like calm with it. I'm just like, man, I just showed her the phone. I'm like, well, who is this? Shawty was speechless. She looked like she seen a ghost. Like she didn't fucking know. She didn't fucking know what to say, nigga. She was just speechless, nigga. She was just like, she was just fucking speechless, nigga. She didn't know what to say. And then, you know, I'm just like, damn, you ain't gonna say sorry. Like, I'm just like, bro, what's up? And, you know, we go through what we go through. And, you know, I put her on timeout, basically. And, you know, we ended up fucking. I'm not gonna lie, we ended up fucking. But this was more so, I was angry fucking. Like, when I say I was taking my pain out on her pussy, bro, she could have said anything, and I'm literally blocking her out, bro. Like, I'm literally fucking the living shit out of her. When I say I'm smacking the shit out of her ass, and I'm literally like pushing her head down, like I'm damn near finna kill ass while fucking, not killing, but like, y'all know what I mean. Like, I'm really passionately, like aggressively dominant, like dominating her ass, bro. Like foot on neck fucking, like Wesley Pipes fucking, like talking shit, you dirty bitch. Look, like I'm talking shit, bruh. Killing her shit. And then after I'm done, nigga, I literally just leave the room. I ain't cuddle, I ain't do none of that lame ass shit, nigga. I just left and went to the gym. But look, I say y'all had to say this, man. The darkness will come to the light, bro. You don't have to go through phones. Even though I went through the phone, because I just needed that clarification. You don't got to do none of that shit, bro. The darkness will come to light, bro. God, do not play. Expect now. On semen retention, I've been cheated on while I was on semen retention. And best believe, I knew. Like, I literally knew I was getting cheated. I was getting cheated on while I was on retention, bro. Like, cause I was 80 days in, right? And bro, it just seemed like everywhere I went, I had signs pointing that, you know, I was getting cheated on. That she was fucking somebody else. And I'm talking about when I say signs, like I literally had insight, bro. Like I didn't even have to ask her if she'd fucked anybody. Like, bro, I knew. Cause my chakras was vibrating so fucking high, bro. I had so much insight and so much brain power, bro. like, retention is fucking dangerous, bro. Like, you have the mental capacity to just, man, the insight you gain on this shit, bro, you gonna know, bro. You don't gotta ask shit. You gonna know when somebody lying, you gonna know when somebody telling the truth, you gonna know when somebody being sneaky, bro. You gonna have the spirit of discernment like a motherfucker. So I say that to say this, bro. Just focus on your purpose, bro. Stay on your grind. And like I said, bro, I'm honoring my oath, bro. Like, I'm literally finna go years on this celibacy semi-retention journey. You can bet my motherfucking balls on that, bro. Literally, the shit that's storing my life force energy, and it's gonna go up my spine, up to my crown, and it's gonna shoot out to the spiritual realm, up to the ascended masters, and they gonna make sure I'm straight, and we gonna be kicking it up top, you know. So, you know, just focus on yourself, kings, player partners. That's what I'm doing, and I'm telling you, bro, I'm enjoying being single. I'm enjoying being committed to my mission, bro. Like, I'm really having fun, and I'm just stress free, bro. I'm so, bro. I was at work yesterday, bro. I was at peace. Cause look, I was at work and I'm seeing niggas arguing with they woman, like nigga arguing the whole shift, literally the whole shift. I'm talking about he stressed the fuck out, and I'm just looking at him like, bro, you do not want to go back to that, Dominic. Stay single. I'm seeing married couples going through it and shit. Niggas coming to the job smoking they motherfucking stress away and all of this shit. And I'm just like, yeah, Dominic, you stay single, bro, because you do not want to go through that shit. Because all that's gonna happen is your peace gonna be interrupted. You're gonna lose out. You're gonna lose money, energy, attention, and time. That's it. And end of the day, sorry, it's. Like, I had a talk with my pops, and he was like, man, this shit ain't about love or none of that shit. Women, and he said, I'm not, man. He's like, if I had a daughter, I would want her to fuck a nigga that's, you know, that she can use. Like, not be a broke-ass nigga that, you know what I'm saying, be sitting on the goddamn couch or sitting in her room playing the game. All right, baby, I'll see you when you get off work, and then come home from work. All right, what you gonna cook? It's like, I wouldn't want no lame ass nigga like that to be fucking my daughter no way. So, you know, I get why women doing that shit. So, you know, respect the game, man. That's why you gotta get yourself together first before you even think about, you know, fucking with a woman. If you ain't got, if you know deep down you got some work to do in all aspects of your life, don't even waste that. Don't waste that woman time. Yeah, don't waste your time, but don't even waste that woman time, bro. Because, you know, women are emotionally invested in that shit, bro. And I know how I be talking shit, saying women don't love you, bro. But some women do really be loving your dirty drawers, bro. And they be like, they go crazy over that good dick. Especially when you got that life force energy. They obsessed with you now, my nigga. You know, especially when you store your shit and you going months and months and years and shit. You think she not, nigga? The woman that you fucked on, she feel your energy the most, cause the soul tie. So she know your energy is rising, my nigga. She feel it more than anybody around this bitch. If you got all these women that's chasing you and shit, and they don't know you, imagine how the woman that know you and fucked on you and you done fucked the dog shit out of her and made her come and all that shit, how she feeling?